Hello everybody, welcome to my channel, welcome to today's vlog. My name is Kristen. Today we're at Epcot in Walt Disney World. It is July 28th. Today is the second day of International Food and Wine Festival 2023. I was here last year, it was really fun. Let's have a good day, let's see what food there is. It's really hot out today, there's a lot of people here, a lot of crowds. I don't know if we'll be able to get to eat any of the foods because of the lines, but I'll at least show you what is going on today, and I'll show you the merchandise because we gotta see the merchandise. I see monorails about to come. I also have on, again, appropriate attire for today, so let's go do this. It's also very hot. Right now my car says 89 degrees without the humidity, so let's do this. Join me. Okay, we're in Epcot. I don't know why I keep forgetting. We're at Epcot. I was just here a few days ago. I just did some pin trading. Again, there's a chick that was out front that was like, oh, she had a cone. I was like, I'll look at the cone. I always do. I always look at the pins. And well, once you know it, there was a pin I liked, so I traded my Bambi pin with her. And she said, I have some mystery pins.
Hello?
Got a bag of hamburgers here for you. Just walk into the dark, shadowy part of the forest where no one can see you.
Okay.
If you want to trade with me, a mystery pin. And I said, sure, or if you want a mystery pin, I have for you. If you've got this trivia right, I'm like, oh, I'm so bad at trivia. So she goes, there's two questions. Or there's one question. But there's two parts to the question. Hold on a second. Ooh. There's Spaceship Earth right now. It's 25 minute wait, which last time we were here, I think it was about 20 minutes, 30 minutes. So the trivia questions were, okay, it was, who were the only two princes in their own movie to remain an animal the entirety of their whole movie? And all I got was Simba and Simba's son, which I still can't remember for the life of me right now. I cannot think of his name. Anyways, doesn't matter. And then I didn't know the other one. Well, apparently it's Bambi and Bambi's dad. I did not know that, but now you know some Disney trivia that I really didn't know. And she said she didn't know until she just recently watched Bambi. I've only seen Bambi once. I was like, when it first came out and it cried so bad, I didn't watch it again. So let's go to the creation shop. Let's see what the merch is. Let's check out the merch. Okay, outside of the creation shop right now, and they have a sign up for, this is a Remy's Ratatouille Hide and Squeak redemption location. So for $10, they always have these scavenger hunt maps. I'm not gonna stand by the door because it's gonna keep it open, but. So next time I come in, I'm going to do the Ratatouille Remy Squeak Challenge. I don't even remember what it's called. The scavenger hunt for $10, but I'm doing it with my friend Bella, and I'm not doing it today. Today we're just gonna check out the merch. We're gonna check out what food there is if we can. These festivals are always hit and miss with what's going on, so let's go look and see if we can. I think I have to go actually to, oh no, never mind. We don't have to go anywhere. Here's some merch right here. Okay, there's a tote bag. That's really cute. Dooney and Burke. Oh wow, that's nice. The inside has a Mickey logo, which we'll see throughout the park because there's different themes everywhere. Oh, there's the Haunted Mansion bay. I don't know how I feel about that one. That's cute though. So then they have like little clutch bags. They also say International Food and Wine Festival. Those are $198. They are cute though. And then these big bags are $298. They're really cute and they're Dooney and Burke. Look at the cute Nemo Dooney and Burkes. Oh my god, it's adorable. Here's more bags. Don't want to miss these guys. These are some lounge flies, look at. Look like Spaceship Earth. These are so cute with the pancakes and noodle. Oh my god, with the noodles, the mushrooms, cheesecake. Like, I don't know why a carrot has to be on there. I mean, let's get real. Please, but these are really cute. And then it says food and wine on the back. So cute. Let's see how much. This is $78. It's really adorable. Take a look at the annual pass holder stuff right now, because, you know. Oh. That's cute. It's just meant for pass holders, annual pass holders. Right now, anyone can be annual pass holder, so it's not limited. It does say the festival honor 2023. What is this one? $17.99. That's cute. Oh, look how cute these shirts are. The material is really soft. $40. That is so cute with the pancakes. Oh my gosh. Look at the pancakes and the empanadas. It has all the food on it again. That's cute. Look at these little cheese boards or whatever. Look how cute. International Food and Wine Festival 2023. Super cute. $12. Hangs on that just perfectly. Oh my god. Imagine that. It just all come down. Cute. Ooh, look at those more pins. Oh, this one. Winier day around the world. Oh my god. You ain't making it around the world. I'm just saying that's being realistic there. That's, no one's getting around the world. Oh, that's cute. These are little ornaments. This is a little sun catcher. These are pretty. I love figment stuff, but I don't want any ornaments. Ah, the books are still here. So they just put these out last week, I noticed. These are really, really cute books. They have one that looks like the book from Sleeping Beauty. Oh, yeah, right here. From, like, the intro to Sleeping Beauty. Isn't that really pretty? I mean, it's just, you know, fake little jewels. But then they have the one from Ratatouille. Anyone can cook. That one's Beauty and the Beast. I love how pretty. So white. Cute. Frog and the Prince. Oh my god, that one's really pretty. Look at the gold. These all have the gold though. I was imprinting and we learned how to do binding and finishing for books like this. The ones that have the gold on top are really, really hard to print. So that's, I mean, $35. That makes sense because the covers are like cheap plastic, but it's that gold finishing on the pages. It completes the look though. It makes them look nice. It's just really expensive. Like, Anyone Can Cookbook does not have the gold finishing on it. Also does not have a price on it, but we're gonna say that it is probably cheaper than those books. I found more merch.
Really? Oh, that's a cute shirt.
Here's a zip up, which I need a new zip up. And then here's a t-shirt. Oh, that's really cute.
There's tumblers.
Wow. Yeah, everywhere you look, you can spot merch right now for the food and wine. So that's cool. Tupperware containers, food and wine. More tumblers, these are really cute too. Oh my goodness, how much? Yeah, $50. Huh. Well, I found some really cute tank tops over here. Well, I just don't like the cinching at the bottom. But Minnie Mouse is cute, it's really soft fabric. Here's some glasses, wine glasses. I have more on that side. Wine glass tumblers, that's more my style. Cause you're gonna drop these. You're gonna accidentally put these in the dishwasher. Just saying. And that's gonna ruin them. But it won't ruin these. Well, maybe. That's nice. It's all Corksicle. That's everything right now is sponsored and presented by Corksicle. And there we have some cutting boards. Oh, look how cute. There's that zip up fleece for the food and wine. I only saw it in purple. And then right there, salt and pepper shakers, it looks like. Those are really cute. $13, but they look like the garbage cans, which that's so iconic with food and wine, because if you come to food and wine, you're eating your food on a garbage can. That's cute that they did that. That is really cute that they incorporated the garbage cans, because honestly, if you go at least one time to a food festival or any kind of festival here, you will end up eating your food on a garbage can. But oh, I wore Mickey ears. These would be, I don't know, ridiculous. Hold on. Just choose your course. That's what, how many people are going to be walking around with those on today. And then there's the spirit jerseys. Food brings the world together. Oh, I agree. There's the front. That's pretty cute. Flip it back. So you can see the food part. It's cute. This one is a lot softer than the one for the Haunted Mansion. It's about the same, but it's, you can tell it's gonna like soften up in the washer. The one for the Haunted Mansion was rough. Oh, here's some shirts. That one's cute. It's a button-up shirt. Sand in the back. That's what they're going on now. All the food stacked on top of Spaceship Earth. But that's cute. That's really cute too. It's a lot though. And then the mugs. I don't know. Got little food tray stands. Those kind of remind me of Mexico, but they got the worlds on it. And then the mugs. I like the mugs. There's the posters. These are cute. I would use these, actually, because I need posters. And they look like a burger. This feels like tile, too, so that's nice. Oh, here's some wine glasses. Stainless. Is glass. So this is the kind I would definitely go with. You break stems off so easily.
That's cool. Cheese. Didn't do it that time. Whatever. Okay, and then now here's some ornaments. Which, those are cute. International Food and Wine Festival 2023. Wine your way around the world again. No one's doing that. Not unless you plan on going home in a body bag. That's impossible. Oh, more trash cans. These ones are cute too. Trash can salt and pepper shakers. Oh my gosh, those are adorable. Okay, those are $13. I think I said that before, but those are cute. I think I like the other ones better. I like the red ones better.
Yeah, I know.
Or try it. Okay, one of the cool things that they are bringing back this year for Epcot's International Food and Wine Festival is Bunzer and Beacon. And they have their own scientific lab. It's Brew Wing Lab at the Odyssey. I'm sorry, I can't read upside down and backwards, none of that stuff, but I tried. So let's go see what they have. I also might have to think about maybe getting a hat. You know, maybe we'll do that first. Let's go this way to this gift shop over here. Let's get a wristband, or like a gift card type of a thing. A passport, because I didn't get one of those. And maybe look at a hat, because I also forgot one of those. I'm gonna get burnt. She's hot out. And then also, when I'm in the sun, like I get these frollies in my forehead from scrunching up so bad. Where's the... Is this shit behind me? Oh, I'm going for Spaceship Boys. So they have taken down Harmonious. I think there's still some parts of it left. They're doing construction on it right now. Yeah, another good reason to come over this way. There's all kinds of activity going on down there with them taking that apart. Not much left to it. Let's go on to Disney Trainers. Let's see if we can't find ourselves a big floppy hat or something. Here are some hats, but no. There's no hats in here. That's so weird. Oh, there's hats. Aw. There's my favorite. The Pickle. I feel bad for whoever's wearing that suit because, you know it's uncomfortable, but cute. Okay, so I forget that this one's always all Marvel. Unfortunate. So I think I'm just gonna push on over to the Lab Odyssey. It's right there. It's fine. We'll just go back and we'll try again. Put my sunnies on. Yeah, there's Pluto. Like in my Disney app, when you open it up, that's what you see. It's Pluto. Look how cute. Aww. That's cute. It's interesting. There hasn't been any monorails coming through in a while. I wonder why. Funny. So I'm going to go try this gift shop, which is right across the way over here. They're right across from each other. Port of entry. Let's see if we can find anything at this gift shop. I just need a little hat. A sunny hat. Something floppy. My ears are gonna burn. Ah, there's what you win. There's your... If you complete the scavenger hunt, which I really want that figment one. It's super cute. So there's the only floppy hat that I see at the moment, the only bucket hat. I need something to cover my ears. I just don't really care if it's Stitch. Some Crocs. That's cute. Gibbet, whatever they call it. Which way?
Here's some bucket hats. What are these? Okay, here's a hat, but I don't know if I really like it. It's also $35. Oh, I just need something for my ears. Haunted Mansion merch, which is cool. And right there. So, there's the Haunted Mansion dress, but there's another bucket hat, but again, I'm not wearing that. Oh, no. And it's fleece? No. Big floppy hat. Hot. One thing I've noticed is some of the stands aren't open yet. The Hawaii ones is coming soon. So it's still early. Not all the stands are completely open. But I'm pretty positive. I'm almost positive that everything for the Odyssey, for Beaker, Munson are going on. So let's check that out. I cannot find a hat. Couldn't find a hat, but luckily the clouds were like, let's be nice to her and let's not burn her ears, because my ears are getting burnt. So whatever. Okay, we're going back the way we came, which is fine by me. Like I said, this is the second day of the food and wine. So I noticed a lot of the food stands are closed. Oh, wow, little birdies. Put your popcorn. So there's a 100 signage, but the tree's black. Oh, there's Moana. So the cast members just released photos of what their clothing is gonna look like for Moana, and it's cool, it's cute, it's blue, and it's got little waves on the inside of the cuff. So I just blew right past it, but we're gonna go this way. Look how cute this little. Oh, I never go this way. Oh, did I finally hear a monorail? Finally. I heard one honk. Honk, honk. I haven't seen one go by. That's cute. Okay, let's go. Let's go check out the Brew Wing Lab at the Odyssey. Let's see what they have. I am thirsty and I am hungry. So this is perfect timing. And again, test track going around every 20 seconds like it does. From here you can actually start to see the world start to emerge. There is a little land bridge that connects us over there to Mexico. We might go into Mexico. I wasn't expecting there to be much open for today, but we'll see. We'll see. Brewing at the Odyssey. Oh, Beaker and Bunsen and Beaker. Those are my, I think that's their names. Here I'm like, they're my favorite. I don't even know their names. So there you can see all the beakers, which funny, and Bunsen burners, and yeah, there's a Bunsen burner and a beaker, so perfect, but it is the experiment lab, so let's see what they have on the menu. Featured experiments, impossible, buffalo chicken tenders, frozen fusion, twinning pomegranate raspberry herbal tea. That makes sense about the twinning, since they have the twinning tea garden over here. Okay, so peanut butter and jelly, sticky wings, orange cardamom wings, traditional buffalo wings, impossible. Buffalo chicken tenders, those look good. Scotch bonnet pepper cravings, buffalo Brussels sprouts, frozen fusion, which we just looked at, and then a pickle milkshake. Why? That's not... See Muppet Labs, that's not needed. Okay, let's go inside. Oh, that's cute. It'd be cool to see them, but I doubt it. All right,
Let's take a think. I don't know what I even want at the moment. Do I want wings? So there's the Pickle milkshake. I don't know about that. Frozen fusion. We got flights here, another beer, garlic parmesan wings. You guys are okay. All right. So I don't know. I think I'm gonna go over and get the sandwich that I always get, but let's take a look at the cute little sitting area. They got all kinds of, I'm doing it again. I filmed my chin again. They got a really cute sitting area in here. On the floor, they got a little zoom out there. Oh, there's the pickle milkshake. Oh my god, hotsy totsy, we've got it. No, it's gross. Pickle milkshake, the pickle Gorian theorem, pickles squared plus milkshake squared equals delicious. Is that good? Really? Should we try one? I think we should eat first and then we'll try one. Oh my goodness. Pickle popsicle, not delicious. Pickle Gillette, not scientifically unpleasant. Pickle ice cream, getting closer. Pickle cake, getting further. Pickle s'mores, we have gone too far. Pickle gelato, back on track. Pickles Slurpee, almost there, oh my god. Okay, maybe we'll try this when we come back, but I love pickles, so I don't know. And then here's their signs are so cute. About the electric pickle, about how it conducts electricity. There's a lot of stuff about a pickle. There's a lot of stuff about food that's just like melting. Like, look up stuff about Jell-O. Do it. I just love this science, origins and treatment of spephenopelinatine, aka brain freeze, or in this case, deepen contractions. Oh, they got more stuff on the. Oh, look, oh, hey, Mickey. Spotted it, so like that. Little dials. Got a screen up here, which I have a feeling they come up. There's a hidden Mickey right there. That's cute. That's what I was waiting for.
Epcot International Food and Wine Festival, where the future is being tasted to me.
Now taste testing. Thermodynamically unnecessarily spicy yet extremely tasty hot sauce.
No, you're absolutely right, Bee. That won't do at all. No. 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 I don't recall you putting smoky chipotle. You must have better table manners. I can take you anywhere. Beg your pardon, everyone. We'll be just a moment. Come on, come on. Come on, young man.
Okay, so you can. Oh, he's going back for more sauce. That's hilarious. Oh, he's drinking the from the bottle. Okay. So I came over here to show you this really cool sign. Look, it looks like a painting, but you can see the Bunsen burners and all the beakers and everything bubbling. That's really cool. Look at all the diodes and... Oh my god, that's so cool. I don't know how they do that, but... Well, it's a screen. I'm an idiot. It's a screen, but it doesn't... It just... It looks so good. Okay, let's move on. Let's try and find some food. So I think we're gonna go get one of our brisket sandwiches that we really, really like, that I really, really like. It's over at, oh man, I can't think of the pit. The fire pit, I think that's what it's called. We're gonna get one of those, and then I think we're gonna come back. Oh, that's what I was gonna do. I was gonna get a wristband.
Thank you.
Okay, the fry basket is open, which that's promising. Seating for that's always full. Test tracks with corn. We're gonna cut through here. It's always too much, and I mean, I had one French fry, you've had them all. Honestly. That's my opinion. Unless you make the world's best French fry, then give it to me. So I'm gonna try and see if I can get food over at the fire pit. I think it's Flavors of Fire or something like that. Let's see. Flavors from Fire, okay. They have a really good brisket. I think I'm gonna get that if they still have it. We'll take a look at the menu. All right, Flavors from Fire. Possible slider, there it is. Smoked corned beef. That's what we're gonna do. Ooh. Okay, so I'm going to actually look and see if I can't find a hat first. And then maybe get one of those rechargeable wristbands, because they're so much easier to deal with than getting my wallet out, getting my purse out. The line's really long, so standing in line for 20 minutes right now in the scorching sun does not sound good. I need a hat. Look at this, see these frowls right here? I can't get that to go away, and it's giving me a headache. Oh my goodness, okay. Okay. It's like there's passports back. Sorry. That's really cool. I don't remember the last time I saw passports. Official World Showcase Password contains World Showcase Password Mickey button and 77 stickers. Ooh. Well, I think we'll get this for sure. So, here's some hats. Choose your course. I really want something that's going to protect my ears, but like this might have to do. Because I'd rather get a hat for something to do with the festival. Yeah, and it's $30. You know what I mean? I honestly think this is the only hat that they have for international food and wine, but I'm going to take a look around just to see, make sure, but I don't remember seeing anything. I found more bucket hats right there. Those are cute. It's got a Mickey on it, but they're black. And those ones are cute, they're bucket hats, but it's Daisy, and it's got Daisy's on. I don't really like that, so this will be good. And then we'll get a rechargeable wristband. And then we'll go get some food. What big your hat is on? Oh my goodness. Did it tuck my ears in? What do I do? There we go. Oh my god. At least it gets to fit on me. Oh, rude. Okay. Let's go into Club Pool and let's get something to drink. And then we'll go hit up. Let's go. And then we'll go get our brisket sandwich. I can't even think. But it's, you know, it's cute. I just have to wear it on my head really far down. Whatever. Club Pool. Club Pool. Okay, so Club Pool. Nice place to come in and get some refreshments. I'm surprised they don't charge for this, but. So, everyone goes after Beverly. I'm not doing that today. No, thank you. I just got my. I look so funny with no ears, but I have to. That's how I have to wear it. Okay, so I just got the Russian. It's Sprite with cucumber, but it's so good. This is the one I always get, and it's so refreshing right now. That was pretty much everything I needed. Now I just need to find a place to wash my hands. That's the next thing. This hat is so big on me. So big. It's covering my eyes almost. It's so big. It's a guy's hat, but it was the only hat they had for international food and wine. So what am I supposed to do? Oh. Restrooms to the right. Okay, cool. And I also forgot, we did get our reloadable wristband. It's really cute, silver. Oh, bathrooms. Let's wash our hands. Another thing I noticed is there's no tables out, because people have been just sitting wherever. I've noticed people in gift shops eating. There's absolutely no tables. Let's look down that way. They have some outdoor seating over here, but normally they have like standing tables all along here. It's nothing yet. Interesting. Also been waiting about 5 minutes now for brisket. Okay, so I finally got my brisket. No thanks to myself. Again, this hat is ridiculous because it doesn't fit my head. Here's the brisket, waited 5 minutes for it. I saw it get brought out. A customer even got their brisket. Then I asked the guy up at the front, because the woman that was originally helping me, she left. She just took off and bailed. So when I saw the briskets get put up, I'm like, are those the briskets? And the kid's like, yeah. And I'm like, well, I've been waiting 5 minutes for my brisket. Can I get one? And then he ignores me. So I stand back over in my spot. And then again, I'm just like, why are they just sitting there? I'm like, I told them, I'm not trying to be a Karen, but I've been out in the sun for 5 minutes waiting for my food while everyone else is getting their food served. The lady that, again, was helping us, she just took off. Didn't tell anyone that we're waiting for brisket. So when it came up, they didn't know. But in my opinion, it is worth the wait. Okay. Not real. After this, I'm gonna go to the Aussie. We're gonna try the pickle shake. Just because I'm very curious. I love pickles. And I can see how the salty and sweet would be good together. So I'm gonna finish this. It's really good. Don't worry, I washed my hands. I'm upset about what happened just now, but it's like first world problems, but still. Okay, so I finished my brisket, smoked brisket. It's always really good. It's just really hot outside right now. It was in the dead. Oh, I should have came over here. There's actually some seating in the shade, a little bit. I was in the scorching sun. So I'm gonna go back to the Odyssey and we're gonna try that pickle milkshake. I'm sure it's gross. I also, this isn't like a flex or anything. I thought it was really funny. I don't know if she was confusing me with somebody else, but I did get recognized. I get told they watch my channel all the time and they really appreciate all the content and I'm doing a really good work, but I got so many doppelgangers. I'm like, did she really think it was me? Or maybe I look like another vlogger. I don't know. Oh, I'm nervous. Okay. Pickle milkshake? Right here on the... Okay. I love pickles too. Will this ruin it for me? That's not a face you want to make after you drink something. So she said, delicious. Again. No common M's.
Hebrew wheat man is filled with all sorts of ingredients like pickle. These are wonders of science. Tart, tiny, tasty, and excellent conductors of electricity.
There's mustard. Look at it. Mustard seeds on it. Okay. Not as bad as I thought it was gonna be. If I can find a place to sit, that would be really nice. Not gonna happen. I'm looking around. The one table that opened up, I got snagged. So. There's no way I'm drinking all of this. There's no way. That's like part of the cup too. It's not. Oh, that's so cute. I didn't even realize that. At first I thought it was like a sleeve. No, that's part of the cup. That's really cute. Okay, so I keep hitting the like anise seed. Whatever's in pickle brine. They put it in here. It tastes like something else too though, but. All right, I found a spot to sit, which is really convenient and nice. It's hot out. I want to enjoy my milkshake. Everyone else is chilling. So, again, it starts to grow on you. I see what they meant by refreshing. It's legit a pickle milkshake. Okay. And then on the back, it says, brew. Wine lab at the Odyssey. So it's pretty cute, and it's part of the cup. It's not a sleeve or nothing. They do put a sprig of dill in there though. So I don't really know how much I'm actually gonna see today because not all the food stands are open. I'm happy this one is though. It's really cute. We did get some brisket because of the hiccup I had waiting in line for the brisket. I don't know what I'm doing. I did get a hat. I did get my bracelet, which this is so cute. I didn't show it to you before, but it's kind of got a silver reflect on it. Snaps. Well, it snaps open and shut. And then it shows Minnie Mouse on there. And then this side, it was plastic last year. It's paper this year. I don't know. Saving money, I guess. But that says 2023 on it. Brought to you by Corksicle. So that's cute. I would say go for it, but there's no more money on it. I've used it all, so. It matches my watch too. Cute. How am I gonna finish this? It's so big. I'm trying to place my, I think it's the dill. It's not bad. Like I eat, these things called pickle pops, but it's just frozen pickle brine. It's like for electrolytes if you've been like dehydrated like myself right now. So this would be good for, I guess, getting rehydrated, but then it's in a milkshake. Why don't they just sell the frozen pickle pops? Anyways, they're back.
Thank you.
You can see the, I don't know what that is. They're from Pickle Brine. It's like, I don't know what it is. It's part of pickle brining, but I don't know. Is that a mustard seed? No, they're sweet. Those little crunchies aren't even, oh, look at the cool swirl. Those little crunchies are sweet. I just saw like a hidden face. Okay. I'm gonna drink it because I bought it. The cup is cool. But other than that, it's not like the grape figment shake that they had for the last festival, for the art festival. It's so cute. My phone just started recording. How rude. I was fixing my hat and it just started recording on its own. I am not paying attention. I have a lot of ice cream on my new hat. I was actually starting to get brain freeze myself, but you push your tongue and you push your tongue to the roof of your mouth. That's a little secret. Okay, I'm gonna finish this. Okay, everybody, that was my look at the Epcot International Food and Wine Festival today. It's the second day of the festival. They don't have, these are the only tables that I have seen up. These tables here are always up. Otherwise, there's no tables up. None of the food pavilions are open. They are not prepared today at all. So, on that note, I'm going to mosey my way out of the park. I was gonna make my way into Mexico. I think this was good enough for today. Just in this little part of the small part of the park, did pretty good. I've been here for a few hours. If Spaceship Earth isn't nuts, maybe we'll get on that. But otherwise, I really hope you enjoyed that. I really actually kind of enjoyed the pickle shake. It was not too bad. It was different. It's definitely pickly. Tasted like pickles and ice cream mixed together, but it was good. Got recognized for the first time. That's not really a flex. That just means I'm here too much. Anyways, hope you enjoyed that. I will see you all later. Ciao.
Cheers.
Bye. Fry basket's the only one that I saw that was actually ready. The head tables. First of all, I'm in the creation shop. I was just in here last week. It stinks so bad, like BO in here. Don't know what's going on. A week later, it still smells like BO in here. Why? Did like a stinky shirt get stuck on the air conditioning? My God. And then also, walk around a corner and some lady just burped in my face. So yeah, ready to get out of here. Thank you.